No, yeah, I think it is. Unsworth, who's come off, and Peter Beegree, tricky winger wearing the number 14 there, right at the forefront of your picture. He seems to be substituted just about every week for Everton, and using him, maybe he can open things up and give Everton a few more attacking options.
Well, I have changed tactically as well, the formation, Ian. What they've got in the name a little bit.
Here's the first chance for Beegree to run at Rob Jones, who may have a busier half as a result of Beegree's introduction. Kenny, not his best ball of the night, though he's done pretty well by and large. No Johnston. Kenny again. 1-2 with Beegree, or with Beardsley rather. Now Beegree again. Kenny. Thought about trying his luck from a long way out once again. Instead, he opted for Barlow on that right hand side and harmlessly behind him. Hammond sold the dummy, but Ablett wasn't buying it. And Ablett does well, playing the 1-2 with Beegree. Spread wide for Barlow. He does well, brings it down. Snowden. Kenny, getting a bit too tight over there, and Barnes comes away. Now Liverpool have 2-on-2 here, 3-on-2 in fact, and it might be 4-on-3 in a minute. Barnes, McManaman making a run to the far post. Here he is, real chance here, he can square it back, and it's cleared away in the end. The effort was
for the safety regulations and what have you these days, and the capacities are much reduced.
Kenny doing well. Beardsley, Johnston, stretching out the leg here. Rosenthal and McManaman in support. Beautifully measured for McManaman. The angle's difficult. It might fall for Rosenthal. And, well, it was some good defending by Martin Keown. Now then, Keown hits. Which defender is up there? That's deliberately played on the volley for Redknapp. And it hit McManaman on the way.
When he was with Wales, and the players were supposed to have a sleep. And Terry Yorath looked out of the window, and there was Neville down on the grass, diving around with no ball for company 2 hours before the match. Great goalkeeper. Now here come Liverpool. Redknapp doing very, very well. McManaman, Redknapp's carried on with his run. Here he is.
Hutchison, Barnes, Everton have got men back now. And one of them is Gary Ablett.
7 red shirts in there.
Wright is one of them! And he scored on his return to the side! Mark Wright breaks the deadlock in the Merseyside derby! Souness celebrates! The Liverpool horn celebrate! And what a comeback for the team for Mark Wright!
Well, you get it from 6 yards. It's awful, it's in the air a long time, but watch this! He goes up almost alone. Mark Keown's not close enough. Southall, there's no chance. Look at Mark Keown there. He jumps behind Wright, and that's fatal.
Beegree with the cross. Hooper's there, though. And Liverpool.
And now their chant from the Liverpool fans to the Everton rivals of going down, going down. They're being taunted. Everton trying to do something about that.
Incredible. Great turn from Maurice Johnston, and it didn't look as if he'd got anything on his shot. Watch this, it's a lovely little ball in from Snowden. Watch him, he turns away from Picnic and deliberately calls a beautiful shot past Mike Hooper. How's that for a reply?
Well, he just loves scoring in derby matches. He did it in this fixture last year. He's done it again this time. The instant riposte from Everton, 1-1, and suddenly this game is alight.
Well, Graham Souness will be absolutely livid. In the same way that Manchester United scored yesterday and allowed City to score almost immediately, Liverpool have committed the same crime. But the one thing you have got now, the game's alive, the stadium's alive, the supporters are in full voice.
Completely different atmosphere now. Nicol. Measured beautifully to McManaman. Rob Jones. And Marsh! Well, he's got a taste for goal lately.
Other man on the bench for Liverpool is Paul Stewart, by the way. Now Beardsley. There's Hutchison. Walters wants his first touch of the ball and gets it. Everton lining up a posse of players. Here's Barnes in his more central role, getting the 1-2. And look at this from Barnes! Oh, how about that? And Everton escape. What a goal that would have been.
That deserved something better than that, didn't it?
Might be more problems here for Everton. Barnes trying to eat this one through, but Everton just riding their luck in that moment. Somebody up there liked Everton a moment or so ago from that shot from John Barnes. Fabulous bit of football though. And that's a very good ball from Kenny out to Farlow. Johnson's in the middle. Beardsley's arriving. Goes all the way. I just thought for a moment there Wright might have left that foolishly, but he knew what he was doing far better than Andy and I sitting up here.
Good call from the goalkeeper. I'm sure it was in that situation. That's a great little ball.
Rob Jones keeps in. Barnes wants it short and gets it. With McManaman. Trying to find half a yard of space. Redknapp. Took a deflection on the way through for the corner.
Yeah. Watch the way he just plays it and runs behind Keown. McManaman supplies a ball. What about that for a strike? Neville Southall, a happy man there to see that come back off his upright.
That almost seemed to defy laws of geometry, didn't it, as well? Barnes is in the swinging corner and Southall has those behind Beagley. And one man you didn't want to give it to was John Barnes. And Beagley rescues it. And an attempted body check from Marsh. And Liverpool get that possession. And look at the space that McManaman has here. Hutchison is in the middle. Barnes is short. Oh, lovely strike again from Barnes off the outside of the foot. Last time out, but can they really ignore a man of John Barnes' quality? You have to ask the question. Beagley. Lovely close control. Beautiful play. Diving header! Just wide of the post again from Mo Johnston.
Well, it doesn't matter how much you dominate a game of great chances. You've got to be tight at the back. And Johnson's ever so close here to giving Everton the lead. He didn't have an awful lot to aim at.
Didn't expect.
But here's the danger every time it breaks down.
Beagley. Beagley against Wright. Still Beagley. And it drops down and it's going to be a goal surely for Beardsley, but no.
You just don't know which way this game going to go. Since he's come on, Peter Beagley, when he's run at people, has caused him problems. Ties Mark right up there. Hooper can't hold the shot. And Beardsley must think that's going in the net. I can't believe it's going wide.
Midfield role. And right out comes on as well. Liverpool pressure, but two amazing let-offs for them at the other end. Mo Johnston and Peter Beardsley so close with headers. Kenny, just 19 years of age, remember. Beagley. Nicely measured for Watson, who's come forward. Look at this from Beardsley. Here's Walters. McManaman waits in the middle. Is it going to reach him? It is. Pulled back. Arms and Marsh both miss it. Paul Stewart. So in the second half, Peter Beagley has made a fairly eloquent statement to Howard Kendall for permanent inclusion in the starting lineup.
Yeah, I think the problem with Howard Peter is he doesn't produce it consistently enough.
Oh, a lovely little touch from Beardsley. Ablett is Beardsley again. It's opening up for him, is it? Yes, it is! Peter Beardsley! He's now scored for both clubs in Merseyside derbies. Only the second man in history to do it. But more important than that, Everton are 2-1 up.
Well, the Everton's Liverpool connection combines quite brilliantly on this wide side. First, Beardsley's artistry, but look at that for a first-time pass from Gary Ablett. And Beardsley's done this too often to be surprised at the concluding result. Just watch the way he controls it in an instant and picks his spot.
Well, what are the Liverpool fans going to be feeling now? How many times have they seen Peter Beardsley do that in a red shirt, Andy?
Well, they certainly won't be surprised, Ian.
Everton have looked increasingly dangerous as it's gone on, and these fans who've suffered so much and seen so little go right for their side, especially at Goodison all season, can now sense a very, very famous victory indeed. Here's Beegree.
It's the first time they've been able to celebrate two league goals.
Redknapp, and there's Jones, and he's beautifully found by Redknapp's inch-perfect ball. Not towards the near post, Barnes is closing in on it, but not as fast as Southall.
And just admire his finish. That's a great first-time pass. Great vision. But look at that for precision finishing.
And for these two, Howard Kendall and Colin Harvey, stars of that famous midfield of 1970. Brent Souness does not look too pleased with life, and you can understand why.
I'd love to be a fly in the wall in their dressing room if it stays this scoreline. He won't be a happy man, and he'll be him very well.
Stewart. There may be another act still. Barnes on the near post with the header. Oh, and how did that stay out?
Oh, that's incredible.
Barlow chasing. Barlow wins. Barlow loses his feet. Oh, dear. It's all happening at the moment, and now he's feeling. One last chance, maybe, for Liverpool. Jones. Everybody's on the far post. Everton get it back again. Beardsley, they're going to look to eat up the time. Barlow is really struggling now. He can hardly run. Well, he can't run. He's walking. Oh, dear. And you just wonder now, 10 men or not, whether he should come off the field and not risk aggravating that anymore.
Well, he's still on. Look,
he's struggling, isn't he, though? Really stays tight hamstring. And there goes the whistle. Everton have won it. It's only their second home win. It's the first time they've beaten Liverpool in a derby since 1987, 1988. That's what it means to those fans in blue. And there's no doubt at all about the Everton hero. It's the former Liverpool player, would you believe? Peter Beardsley with a late winner.
You think they've just won the cup final. This is how important I felt that this game was to Everton tonight. And how Kendall's players have provided them with a magical answer to all the questions that were being asked about the side.
And there's your check on the match facts. Liverpool going ahead with Mark Wright on 64 minutes. Back came Mo Johnston with the equaliser within 2 minutes and 5 minutes from the end. Peter Beardsley. Everton 2, Liverpool 1. It's a famous night for Everton. It could be a turning point for them down near the foot of the table. As Andy says, mass celebrations at Goodison Park. And they're really going to enjoy this evening. And when they get back in the offices and factories and pubs and clubs around Merseyside, there'll be a good bit of banter going on. But as Richard Keyes was saying at the top of the programme, it's very much friendly banter around here. Great night for Everton, and after all they've been through this season down near the foot of the table, you can't take it away from them. Let's meet the Everton hero tonight, Peter Beardsley, down there with David Livingstone.
Peter, only the second man to score for both teams in Liverpool derbies. What did it mean to you?
Well, it meant everything, you know, getting the winning goal. I mean, it took me straight, and luckily it went in the bottom corner. Well, please.
Peter, what does it mean to the team?
Hopefully that'll give us a big lift, you know. I mean, we have been struggling a bit, especially at home, but, you know, there's no better feeling than winning a derby game, and hopefully that'll set us up for the rest of the season.
Well done, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Everton 2, Liverpool 1, and the customary Monday night fireworks. What a fabulous second half that was. What a weekend on Sky Sports.